As with all exercise, please use common sense in a safe environment. To reduce and avoid injury, you will want to check with your doctor before beginning any type of fitness program. By performing any exercises, you're performing them at your own risk. AGA Northwest will not be responsible or liable for any injury or harm you sustain as a result of the information shared on our YouTube video. Enjoy.
Hi, AGA kiddos. Coach Nicole here. We're going to do something a little different this week. Gymnastics is not only just doing big skills and running and having a lot of power. A lot of it is dance-based. So you'll notice in girls' gymnastics, they do dance on the balance beam. They also do it on the floor. So we're going to do a whole session of dance-based stuff. We're going to start off with an 8 count that we're adding to music. Super simple. We can make it faster or slower, but Coach Bella is going to lead us through that today. And then we're going to transition to some yoga. Yoga's really great for learning how to breathe. When you're doing a floor routine, you have to know how to breathe properly so that you have energy for all of the skills that you need and your dance movements. And then we're going to, the last portion of today's practice is going to be doing just basic dance moves that we do with all the big girls. So I hope you're keeping yourselves busy. Please utilize these videos every week. Do as many of them as you can. If you're a star or a super shot or a hot shot or even a team kid, check out the other videos on our channel and try to challenge yourself. So we miss you so much. We'll see you soon.
Okay, one of the easiest and best ways to learn how to dance with music is creating an 8 count. And an 8 count is where we have 8 different movements to which we add to a song. Usually in music, if you have an 8 count and you put it into the song and you count it correctly, it keeps looping over every 8 count. So you can keep repeating it. Today we're gonna focus on 2 different 8 counts. The first one we're starting with is just basic isolation stuff. So it's not a lot of movement. It's kind of like powerful in a hit. You'll notice Simone Biles is very aggressive in her movements. She's not as flowing. So we'll do 2 different kinds today. The first one's gonna be a little more direct and static. So we're gonna take a step. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, reach the arm 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're gonna bend and open our arms one at a time. Bend, open, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, we're gonna go hands on the waist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're going to repeat it. So it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As we go along and you feel more comfortable, start getting sassy with it. So it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hand and hand and turn, turn, turn. So get sassy with it. All right, let's do this. Okay, you guys, now I want you to take that same 8 count, those same 8 movements, and pick a different song. Then I want you to try to match those movements to the song of your choice. Okay, you guys, we just kind of did the fun Simone Biles-esque 8 count to some music. We're gonna slow it down a little bit and do something a little more graceful. If you're familiar, Nastia Liukin is an Olympic champion, and she's much more graceful. She's her style is much more elegant. Both are really cool and fun. We have to find what style works for you when we give you a floor routine, and that is our job, and we're really good at that. So what we're gonna try to do is a very different style right now for an 8 count. I want you to stand nice and relaxed with your feet slightly apart, and we're just gonna do some basic arm movements. Let's go back a little bit. So the first count of 8 is we're going to go up to the side, nice and soft. You're gonna pretend you have mud on your fingers and you're wiping it off of your body, lifting your arm up,
And then the elbow comes down first, then the wrist, then the fingers. We're going to switch sides as well. It's going to be elbow up first, reach up to the ceiling, and then elbow down. Then we're gonna go up the front, but we're gonna push that mud down to the floor and reach up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Push the mud out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're gonna cross our arm over our body and do what I call it is a rainbow. So we're gonna reach over across your body, elbow bent, 1, 2, 3, 4, turn the hand over, 5, 6, 7, 8. And other arm, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let's go over this again. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Get ready for rainbow. 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn 6, 7, 8. Switch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's get it going. Okay, ladies, another challenge. I want you to take that same 8 count, find a softer song of your choice, and try to add it to the music. Good luck. Okay, ladies, let's move on to some breathing exercises with Coach Bella. First, you're gonna start in a straight body position. Take a big, deep breath in and blow it out. After you're relaxed, what we're gonna do is working on getting into salutation. Bella pulls her hands together, takes a big, deep breath in and out, and slowly reaches up towards the sun to a high stretch. Make sure that you continue those breaths. After you've held it for 4, you're gonna return to earth in a squat. As you feel your hands on the floor, you're gonna slowly reach back with your leg and position yourself into a long lunge. Take a big deep breath in, 1, 2, 3, 4, and blow it out. Then slowly move the other leg back and move your hands backward so your bottom is up in the air for downward dog. Hold downward dog for 4 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then slowly lower yourself down to earth. Take a big deep breath in on your stomach, let it out, and then slowly arch yourself up like a seal into cobra. Once you've held cobra for 4 seconds, you're gonna reverse this whole series. Lay back down, count to 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Push yourself back up to downward dog, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pull your foot in front for a lunge. Push that hip down, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pull the other foot in for return to earth in a squat position. Gauge your tummy, slowly reach up to the sun in high stretch, and then slowly pull your hands together for sun salutation. Okay, ladies, we're gonna repeat this whole section again, except Coach Bell is gonna show you from the side. Start in a stretch position and slowly move your hands into sun salutation. Take a big deep breath in and blow out as you reach to the sky in high stretch. And then we're slowly moving down to return to earth in a squat position, keeping your core tight. And then move the leg backwards into that lunge. Breathe 1, 2, 3, 4. Hands on earth. And push your shoulders down in downward dog. And then slowly lower yourself down to your belly. Take a big deep breath in
As you blow out, push your chest up to the sky for cobra. Take a big deep breath in and blow out. Push back into downward dog. Pushing your shoulders down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Move your foot in. Lunge. 1, 2, 3, 4. Pull the back leg in to return to earth in a squat. Hold for 4. Then slowly reach up in high stretch. And then pull your hands down and send salutation.
Great job, girls. Now, Coach Bella is going to get in a seated position, crisscross applesauce. She's going to take her hand and place it on her belly because we're going to do a couple breathing exercises before we stretch. Let's take a big deep breath in for 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and blow out. 1, 2, 3, 4. And breathe in. 2, 3, 4. Out. 2, 3, 4. And again. In. 2, 3, 4. And out. 2, 3, 4. Now Coach Bella is going to transition into a straddle stretch. We're going to practice on doing those breaths as we're stretching. Our muscles need the oxygen in order to release and allow us to go down further. So Coach Bella is going to reach over her left leg and we're going to work on our breaths. Breathe in, 1, 2, 3, 4, and blow out, 2, 3, 4, in, 2, 3, 4, and out, 2, 3, 4, switch to the other side. In, 2, 3, 4, out, 2, 3, 4, breathe in, 2, 3, 4, and out, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna stay seated in the straddle stretch, and now Coach Bella is gonna flip her hands over, palms to the floor, and reach and bounce over her leg 8 times. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and then switch to the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we reach in the front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Great job, Bella. Now we're going to transition into rainbow reachovers. You're starting down in your foot and slowly reaching over your head. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold for 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Reach over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Now Coach Bella is going to do windmills where she scoops her arm in front, reaches behind her, and lifts her hips. And we scoop in front, reach, scoop in front, reach, pushing that hip forward, scoop in front, reach, and scoop in front, and reach. Great job, Coach Bella. Now we're going to move on to some of our basic passes. These are all dance passages that are added into choreography once you get your own routine. You'll notice when Coach Bella is doing these movements, she's doing them with straight legs and pointed toes. Right now we're working on the chasse, which is 1 foot in front and the other foot skips behind. Push and push and push through your feet. Good job, Coach Bella. Arms in airplane arms. And again, chassés. Arms in airplane, and second, and chasse. Now Coach Bella is doing the side chasse, hands on your waist first. Make sure you're plieing, which is bending both knees between the chasse. Bend and push, bend and push. And then she's gonna do it again with her arms in second position, airplane arms. Good job. See how her feet are kissing at the top of the chasse, and she's pushing through her feet. Continuing on our movement basics, Coach Bella is going to go into kicks. You'll notice that her arms are starting in second position or airplane, and as she steps forward, she kicks the leg, pointing her foot and kicking as high as she can. Coach Bella is almost kicking her nose on her right leg. Once you get to the end of the pass, it's really cool and important to do a pivot turn. We'll go over pivot turns in just a moment. Next, we're going to go into the side kick. I'm having Coach Bella face you, so you can see exactly how it's done. Her arms are starting in second position, and she's going to kick to the side, up by her hand, and then back down, and up by her hand and back down. She's keeping her legs straight, just like she was in the forward kicks. So now she's going to add that movement into a pass. Side kick, step side kick. Make sure that you're keeping your chest upright and your arms are nice and firm in second position. Try really hard to make sure you're doing at least 2 to 4 passes of each of these. The more you do, the better you're going to get. Now Coach Bella is going to teach you the back kick. She's going to continue walking forward. She's going to kick her leg behind her. You'll notice that it looks like she's almost flinging mud off of her foot behind her as she kicks, and then takes a large step forward to continue forward movement. She's keeping her arms in second position, her legs are nice and straight, and she's not leaning forward when she's kicking back. This is perfect for split jumps and split leaps. Okay, moving on to the next activity. Coach Bella is going to show you the arm path in which we're using next. She's going to start with her arms down, she's going to scoop them up into a crown position. I always tell my girls to pretend like they're putting a giant crown on their head, like they're the biggest princess in the world. She's moving her arms up and then back down. It's like a swinging action. Now Coach Bella is going to teach you how to use the leg kick we just learned with a little bit of a hop. She's scooping her arms up into that crown position and kicking her leg forward. Make sure you're doing both legs, not just your favorite one. She takes a large step and jumps with a kick, and then her arms go up to crown as well. Okay, who doesn't like a little footwork? Coach Bella is going to show you some heel raises. You'll notice she's starting with her ankles together, and she's trying really hard to keep them together as she raises her heels off the floor and keeps her toes down. This is getting us ready for turns. This is also strengthening our calf muscles, which is super important, and also helps prevent rolling our ankle. After Coach Bella has completed 2 sets of 8 heel raises on both, she's going to transition to singular foot raises. Her other foot is held up at her ankle, which is called coupe, and she's trying to lift the 1 foot up 8 times. This is incredibly difficult. Make sure you're doing it on both feet, so you're strengthening both ankles. Now that your ankles are in beast mode, let's do a pivot turn. 1 foot is in front of the other, and you're starting on high tiptoes in your crown position. You're going to snap halfway around and then snap back. Keep those legs straight and no heels touching. Okay, challenge time. Let's see if Coach Bella can do 8 in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great job, Bella. Her heels didn't touch once. Now that you've learned the pivot turn, we're going to go into the heel snap turn. Coach Bella is standing on her favorite foot, her other foot in coupe, and she's showing you the path of her arms. This is called prep position. Prep position is where one arm that is the same as the leg you're standing on is bent in front, and the other arm comes from the side and pulls in front. Sometimes I call this the Santa belly. So start in the prep position and scoop your arms in for Santa belly. Prep and scoop. Prep and scoop. And prep and scoop. Those were quarter turns for heel snaps. Now Coach Bella is going to try to challenge herself and do a heel snap turn halfway around. So she's going to stand on her favorite foot, put her other foot in coupe in a prep position, and snap half. Again, arm opens and scoop to Santa belly. Hold. Very nice, Bella. We're going to move on to half turns, but you need to learn how to finish out of the half turn before doing it. So Coach Bella is going to show you out of the half turn, you're going to bring your foot forward, point the other foot back, and reach up to the sky and lift your chin. Step forward, chin up, finish. You'll see this in the Olympic Games. Now Coach Bella is going to show you from the side. She puts her favorite foot out in front, turns, and then finishes. This is called a half turn. Puts her favorite foot out in front and prep, scoops her arms to crown, and finish. Okay, once you've mastered the half turn with the big finish, you're gonna try a full turn. If you're in your house, it's best to try this with socks on nice and slow. Coach Bella has her favorite foot out in front in prep position. She's gonna scoop to crown and make a 360 turn with a big finish. Excellent job, Coach Bella. That's it for this week's workout. Keep practicing, ladies. Good luck, good skills, and go AGA.